Scunthorpe United Reading Stars is a programme that uses the motivational power of football to inspire students to read more and to improve their literacy skills. We're also sometimes lucky enough to attract authors to get involved in the programme to deliver workshops.
I also read in here about young footballers being taken illegally from one country to another in Africa, which is called trafficking. So when I read about that in here, I went to Ghana in Africa and found out.
Children often ask me, what was your ambitions when you were young? And I genuinely didn't have any ambitions. And until when I started reading, though, it gave me, I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that, I wanted to go to places because I'd read about them. And reading stories and non-fiction really gave me ambitions and confidence, really. I started writing when I was about 20. I didn't like reading until I was 17, but my mum eventually got me into it using football and giving me the confidence. I truly believe that reading is at the core of a good society and civilisation. And the idea is to use the passion and love of football amongst children, especially children who aren't that confident about reading, to encourage them to read for pleasure. We were really lucky to have some of the players along today, and they were great. They went in goal for us. The kids enjoyed meeting them, and I think the kids really benefited from hearing that footballers read magazines about fitness, read biographies of other players.
Has reading been
more of other players as well. And like I was saying earlier on, I have two young children now as well, so. Yeah. Night times I read to them a lot. Well, try to anyway, and they read to me. Yeah.
Schools get involved by identifying a group of students who they think would most benefit from the programme, and then we structure the programme around a series of literacy lessons, some that are based at the schools and some that are based at the stadium.
So we chose a group of children who I would label as reluctant readers, people who would read if they were forced to read, basically, and hadn't really found their love of reading. And so taking them out of the school environments where I think they felt there was pressure on them to read, taking them to a different environment where they looked at reading in a different aspect, really, from having role models there, so the author that was there, realising why people need to read and the importance of it, has really helped those children to inspire them to read more.
But one of the things that we are here today is just to talk to you about reading and how important it is. Not just as reading goes as you are now, but also about reading, about how important it is when you go through life and even to a point of when you start working.
First and foremost, I'm very honoured to be part of Reading Stars, and using football as a vehicle to inspire children to get reading again is something I'm very honoured to do.
Yeah, I'm very fortunate to work with a football manager who, again, could inspire you as a person, just by words.
Already we've seen some huge improvements over a short period of time, and today is no different. It's been very, very inspiring. Children have been very enthusiastic, and you can already see that they're already engaged in reading.
There's a good girly word.
Yeah.
There's some really strange words, aren't there?
In my early days, I couldn't really get inspired about reading, and it was only my old school teacher, Mr. Burnside, who was very strict. He asked me one day what's my hobbies and what did inspire me and what do I enjoy doing. And of course my first thing was football, and he went away and come back with some magazines about football, just magazines. And magazines were my first real introduction of reading more intensely. And of course, I couldn't put them down once I had started.
All about my life in football. So again, you know, I'm very honoured and privileged to have done something like that. And that's all from the day that my English teacher dropped these magazines on my lap and said, go on, have a read of these. That inspired me. And then years and years later, I was very lucky to write my own book.
They've been to a graduation ceremony. at Scunthorpe United themselves and were given certificates there in front of all the parents and things as a reward ceremony.
Today are among the first graduates of Scunthorpe United Reading Stars, and we are delighted that you've been able to join us for this celebration event.
It's important that whatever inspires you as a child, please pick up a book about it, because you never know, it's something that will really create something for you.
And today we've also given certificates out from the Reading Stars that Brian's now signed as well. And I think they were just so enthused that he was coming and they could ask him the questions that I couldn't answer.
I've read Gangster Granny. Have you read that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was amazing as well. It was really quite funny as well.
I've still got the book, so I might read it, because I've got two other David Rowling books.
Reading is important. It's probably, I would say, the most important skill that we can give them at school.